Hi students, this is Dinesh here. Today we are going to discuss exercise 2.8 and question number 6. If omega is not equal to 1 is a cube root of unity, show that the roots of the equation z minus 1 the whole cube plus 8 equal to 0 or minus 1 comma 1 minus 2 omega comma 1 minus 2 omega square. So let us take the given equation z minus 1 the whole cube plus 8 equal to 0. Now z minus 1 the whole cube is equal to minus 8. Now z minus 1 the whole cube is equal to minus 8. We can write minus 1 into 8. So z minus 1 is equal to, now I am going to take this cube taking to right hand side. So minus 1 the whole power 1 by 3 into 8 power 1 by 3. So z minus 1 is equal to minus 1 the whole power 1 by 3. Into 8 we can write 2 power 3 the whole power 1 by 3. Now here cube and cube get cancelled, this cube and this cube get cancelled. So z minus 1 is equal to what? Minus 1 the whole power 1 by 3 into 2. Z minus 1 is equal to, already we know that minus 1 is equal to cos pi plus I sin pi, because cos pi value minus 1, sin pi value 0. So we can write minus 1 is equal to what? Cos pi plus I sin pi. So now z minus 1 is equal to cos pi plus I sin pi the whole power 1 by 3 into 2. So now z minus 1 is equal to 2 into cos pi plus I sin pi the whole power 1 by 3. So now add 2k pi. So this pi, in the pi under the theta. So theta could add 2k pi add panna. So now z minus 1 that is equal to what? 2 into cos 2k pi plus pi plus I sin 2k pi plus pi the whole power 1 by 3. So now 2 into cos 2k plus 1 pi plus I sin 2k plus 1 into pi. I'm going to take pi outside. Here also I'm going to take pi outside the whole power 1 by 3. So applying de Moivre's theorem. So cos theta plus I sin the whole power n. That is equal to cos n theta plus I sin theta. Here cos theta plus I sin the whole power n. So this n I am going to multiply here. So 2 into cos 2k plus 1 into pi by 3. Pi into 1 by 3 that is equal to pi by 3. Plus I into I sin 2k plus 1 pi into 1 by 3 that is equal to pi by 3. So here the value is 3. So we can take k values 0, 1, 2. These 3 values. If here value is equal to 4. So now I am going to take k value 0, 1, 2, 3. So now I'm going to substitute k value equal to 0. Here 2 into cos 2 into 0 what? 0 plus 1, 1 into pi by 3 cos pi by 3 plus I sin. Here also 0 plus 1, 1 into pi by 3, pi by 3. So z minus 1 is equal to what? 2 into cos pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 3. So z minus 1 is equal to what? 2 into cos pi by 3, it means what? Cos 60 degree, that is equal to 1 by 2. Plus I sin 60 degree that is equal to root 3 by 2. So already we know that cube root of unity 1 omega omega square. So omega is equal to what? Minus 1 plus I into root 3 by 2. And omega square is equal to what? Minus 1 minus I root 3 by 2. Now I am going to take minus omega square that is equal to what? Minus 1, sorry, 1 plus I root 3 by 2. This is the minus omega square. So 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2 that is equal to what? Minus omega square. So 2 into minus omega square minus 2 omega square. So z is equal to what? Minus 1 I am going to take right hand side. So 1 minus 2 omega square. This is the one of the root. Next I am going to substitute k value 1. So what you'll get? Cos 2 into 1 plus 1, 3. 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 pi plus I sin 3 pi by 3. Here I am going to substitute 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So 3 pi by 3 plus I sin 3 pi by 3. That is k value 1. So now, so that is the answer here. When k equal to 1, z minus 1 is equal to 2 into cos 3 pi by 3 plus I sin 3 pi by 3. Here 3, 3 get cancelled. Here also 3, 3 get cancelled. So 2 into cos pi plus I sin pi. Already we know that cos pi value minus 1, sin pi value 0. So 2 into minus 1 minus 2. So z minus 1 is equal to minus 2. So z equal to what? Minus 1 I am going to take right hand side, 1 minus 2. So z equal to 1 minus 2, that is equal to minus 1. This is another root. Already we found What is the root? Z is equal to 1 minus 2 omega square. Here, Z equal to minus 1. Next, when k equal to 2, I am going to substitute. So, 2 into cos 2k plus 1 into pi by 3. So, 2 into 2, 4. 4 plus 1, 5 pi by 3. Plus I sin 5 pi by 3. 5 pi by 3, it's nothing but 5 into pi by 3 means what? 60 degree. 5 into 60, which is equal to 360. So, 360 we can write 360 minus 60. 360 means 2 pi. 60 pi by 3. So, we take cross multiply 2 into 3, 6 pi. 6 pi minus pi, 5 pi, the whole divided by 3, the as usual. So, 5 pi by 3, we can write 2 pi minus pi by 3. So, now I am going to substitute 5 pi by 3, I am going to change 2 pi minus pi by 3. So, z minus 1, that is equal to what? Cos 2 pi minus pi by 3 plus I sin 2 pi minus pi by 3. Already we know that 2 pi means what? 360. Already we know that cos 360 minus theta, that is equal to cos theta. Cos 360 minus theta, which quadrant? That is fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant, all silver. See here. Here all positive. Here cos positive, sin negative. Say both are negative. Here fourth quadrant, all silver tea cups. So C means what? Cos theta positive. So cos positive and the reciprocal secant positive. So here first quadrant all positive, second quadrant sin theta positive, others negative, and sin and the reciprocal cosecant positive. Third quadrant tan theta positive and reciprocal cot theta positive, others negative. And fourth quadrant, this is what? 0 degree, this 90 degree, this 180 degree, this 270 degree, this 360 degree. So 360 minus theta, that is equal to what? 360 minus theta in fourth quadrant. Cos 360 minus theta, that is equal to cos theta, because cos is positive. So cos 2 pi minus pi by 3, that is equal to what? Cos pi by 3. So this is equal to 2 into cos pi by 3 plus sin 360 minus theta minus sin theta. So minus I sin pi by 3. So that is equal to cos 60 degree value 2 into root 3 by cos 60 degree 1 by 2 minus I into root 3 by 2. That is equal to, already we know that omega is equal to what? Minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2, and omega square is equal to minus 1 minus I root 3 by 2. Here the value of omega is equal to what? Minus 1 plus I root 3, the whole divided by 2. So here minus omega, that is equal to what? Minus 1 means negative. So 1 minus I root 3, the whole divided by 2. So now I am going to take the value of 2 into 1 minus I root 3, the whole divided by 2, that is equal to what? Minus omega. So minus omega. The left hand side value is z minus 1. So z is equal to, so z is equal to minus 2 omega plus 1. So z is equal to 1 minus 2 omega. This is the other root. So already we know that one first root minus 1 and second root 1 minus 2 omega and third root 1 minus 2 omega square. The roots are minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 omega, 1 minus 2 omega square. This is the answer for this subdivision. Okay, the roots are minus 1, 1 minus 2 omega, 1 minus 2 omega square. This is the answer for this subdivision. Okay, thank you children.